alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and Charles, kickoff moments away. Quickly, what are you watching in this one?
The offensive line for both teams, because both teams have a terrific pass rush. They've got to keep their passers upright. If they have a chance to do that, they can both thrive on offense and move the ball downfield.
Greg Zuerlein now, he'll handle the honors to get us started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. That's fielded in the end zone. First run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Ray Lewis up from his linebacker spot to make the play.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
And he's got the hook up to Landry. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Now Breeze. Now Breeze lost the football. And the Packers pick it up. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score. And a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands and try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
We'll be singing in the shower postgame. Zuerlein good with a PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive, then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You've just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
NFL quarterbacks work so hard on their mechanics, and they do so much repetition and practice, off-season, the whole deal. They expect it to be autopilot once the game starts. That way it eliminates any type of pressure of the game, pressure of people in your face, all of that. That didn't shine through on that throw, though, did it?
No. A little bit of a dangerous pass and off target, too. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, it's Breeze. For Clark again, and this time he's got him. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down. This is Ingram on 1st and 10. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
On 1st down, Breeze into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former Super Bowl MVP, Malcolm Smith. And into the end zone, it's a pick 6 and a Packer touchdown. And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick 6, and just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visits. What do we hear during these drills? Pass. Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Madden Legends heading back onto the field. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for Adjustments come in as they're going to stop him behind the line.
Early down steps have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
Well, as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, I mean, you know how much coaches love run after catch, but you know what they love even more? Completion.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it, cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
They do go for it. It's Breeze. And this is caught. He hits Landry. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. On first and 10, here's Breeze. He goes underneath to Ingram. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it's a second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to press your receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. Breeze now rebounding nicely after the interception. He's hit 4 straight to start the drive. It's first down. They'll run it for the first time with Ricky Williams. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. On second down, here's Breeze. Over the middle, that's complete to Clark. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Breeze now on first down. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked off by the 13-time Pro Bowler, Ray Lewis. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
When a team's turned it over 3 times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. 2 interceptions, 1 caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
So here's Vic following the interception. And that will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. A second down throw for Vic. Flush to his right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. LaMarcus Joyner able to run him down for a loss of a yard. On third down, Vic. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. On the counter, Ingram. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but. Yeah, let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Now a play fake here on first down. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Vic operating on first down. Forced out to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Hey, let's go!
Vic on second down. Being chased out left. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And it's third and four.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. Flushed out right. Here as he's taken down, Jurrell Casey, able to run him down for a 15-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. Here goes Vic on fourth down, buying time to his left. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. So a minute 55 to go in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now Breeze throwing on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Breeze now to throw. Dancing to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep. Man, it's caught inside the 10. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run here with Ingram. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
21.
Breeze to throw on second down. Steps away to his left. This is caught. Clark. And now prior to this third and one, we're going to get a timeout here. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense so far on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and goal. Oh, the keeper, it's Breeze. The keeper nets him only a yard, and that's going to bring up fourth.
To me, this isn't even a question. I think that they'll go. When they have a chance to put a dent in the lead, even with a whole second half to play, I think they have to do it. This isn't a risk. This is a necessity.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more.
Good, good, good. By four, right.
They're running. Ingram. And this will be a touchdown. Mark Ingram taking it in. And the Madden legends draw a bit closer. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. And a lot of football, full half to be played. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Just over 30 seconds to go in the half. They've got it first and 10. 45. A first down throw coming for Vic. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Vic will look to throw on first down. Escaping the pressure right. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Throwing, Vic, forced out to his left. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. They'll throw again. Here's Vic. And incomplete. Almost intercepted. The D lineman almost had it. Couldn't hang on. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. Vic to the air again. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10. Final shot before half for Breeze. Going deep here for Landry. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. First, you want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Hey, let's
go. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. First down, Vic. And an alley to run. Fights him off. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Now a second down throw for Vic. On the check down, he finds Kamara. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
He's got it with the 15. It's a big play for the Pack on third. 43 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
There's Michael Vick. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Deion Sanders in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. So after the sack here, second and 14. Vic now. Eluding the pressure. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. LaMarcus Joyner in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the gun, Vic. And Nelson's got it here right side. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Jordy Nelson, 27 yards. And the Packers add on to their lead. Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and it's now 21-7. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. No gain on the play there. Second down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it third down. Now Breeze being chased out left. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Nothing open downfield, and he had to get that one out in a hurry because he just knew he was about to take a big shot. Probably couldn't get his legs into the throw. Became an all-arm throw trying to check it down to his running back. Incomplete.
So here we go on fourth down to Breeze. And quickly it was tight end Clark that's caught. They're able to keep the drive alive. 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Now Breeze. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. He's picked off at his own 46. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And the offense is able to pounce on it inside the 5-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, Let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now a handoff. Here's Williams. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than two, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to six. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go four. I don't know about six.
Come on, come on. Come up to six.
A lot of points.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Vic now 8 of 15 through the air, but it's first and 10 here. From the shotgun, it's Vic. Buying time to his left. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
This is caught inside the 15. And all the way inside the 15. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. From the red zone now, Vic. Flush to his right. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up a blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage. Dancing to his left. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. First down, Breeze. And my goodness, another interception. Eddie Jackson picks it, and he'll return it to the 24. 24-